Bates is regular meeting of the Putnam Legislature for Tuesday, February 6th. We advise for the pledge of allegiance. Legislator Yankee, will you lead us in the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And if you can remain standing for the legislative prayer, Legislator Albano.
Gathered to make our decisions for our community, may we use the best skills and judgment, keeping ourselves impartial and neutral as we consider the merits and pitfalls of each matter that are placed before us, and as always, act in accordance with what is best for our community and our fellow citizens.
Thank you. Can I have roll call?
District one, Legislative Scott Chiara.
Present.
District two, Legislative Bullock.
Present.
District three, Legislative Adenizio.
Present.
District four, Legislative Nasrino.
Present.
District five, Legislative Albano.
Present.
District six, Legislative Yankee.
Present.
District eight, Legislative Sage.
Here.
District nine, Legislative Sullivan.
Present.
District seven, Chairman Gastelum.
Present. Item number four is the approval of minutes for regular meeting of December 5th, 2017, the year-end meeting of December 20th, 2017, and the organizational meeting of January 2nd, 2018. Item number five on our agenda is correspondence from the county auditor. And we have one item recently. It's a refund for the school district of Carmel. The amount was $1,155.96. Fiscal impact of $82.50. So we'll move on to pre-filed resolutions. Item number six, so I call upon the Personnel Committee, Legislator Nasrino.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. On behalf of myself and Legislators Yankee and Sullivan, I would like to move forward with the following items. And I would just like to preface by saying that we are always looking to seek efficiencies, and that holds true for personnel issues as well. Tonight I will present prime examples of how we have balanced experience, talent, and expertise with our taxpayer dollars. Item 6A is a request for a budget transfer for $20,000 for the position of project coordinator and safety officer. Excuse me. This is a position that would be a person that would be in a shared position and receiving this stipend. This person is has done a stellar job, and I'm very confident, as we all are, that he will excel in the position as he undertakes new responsibilities. And by combining positions, we are improving efficiencies and indeed saving taxpayer dollars. That being said, I would like to move forward with a budget transfer of $21,530. And I would also like to note that in Resolution 250 of 2017, setting the salaries for officers and employees paid from county funds is hereby amended to reflect the title change and stipend, which is effective January 1st, 2018.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Item 6B is the approval budget transfer of county executive personnel, and this is necessary to restore the Director of Constituent Services salary line, which was reduced in 2018 in the adopted budget because the county had not received a Section 2011 waiver from the State Civil Service Commission. However, that waiver did come forth, and the salary is now being adjusted. So I would like to move forward with a budget transfer in the amount of $9,150 to reflect that. Again, resolved with Resolution 2060 of 2017, setting the salaries of officers and employees paid from county funds is hereby amended to reflect this revised salary, the Director of Constituent Services salary, to $44,500.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Item 6C is approval budgetary amendment, Sheriff's Department staff reorganization and title change. This is at the request of Sheriff Langley, who has requested budgetary amendment to change salary of two confidential secretary positions in his department, and the position of confidential secretary to the sheriff, which was adopted as, for $71,100, is reduced to $63,990, and the title change of to be chief of staff, and the position of confidential secretary to the unsheriff will be reduced from $58,526 to $52,673. This will realize a cost savings of $12,963. So I would like to move this forward to reflect that change. This is a, with FICA, and this is a realized impact fiscal savings of $13,935.
Any discussion?
I'd just like to say, reiterate what was said at the audit committee meeting. I appreciate, I support the sheriff's reorganization of his staff. I appreciate your saving the taxpayers almost $13,000, and we all appreciate the job you're doing.
Again, I would like to reflect that in accordance with Resolution 260 of 2017, says salaries of officers paid from county funds is hereby amended to reflect the positions which will be effective retro January 1st.
Any other discussion? I too would like to say that, you know, it's a fair compromise. We had an open discussion in committee, and I think this is going to be great for Putnam County and for the sheriff's department. I look forward to seeing who we hire and doing the right thing for Putnam County and the sheriff's department. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Moving on to Fiscal Services Committee, appointment of Chairman Alabama.
Thank you. On behalf of legislators Castellanos, Cujamar, and myself, I'd like to move 6E, approval of a budgetary amendment, Highways and Facilities Utilities Table Contract. This is an accounting process, and we're putting $30,000 in the contracts in anticipation of revenues until this table. On a positive note, it's been a certain time to the last few weeks, and places looking beautiful, and you can see the potential. It's really great things that happen.
Any other discussion on the other?
Yeah, from one of the facility, if you haven't had the opportunity to stop by, you really should.
I agree. The food is terrific, and they've got some wonderful events planned for the next couple of months. We had a presentation from a young lady who was going to do with Alice in Wonderland. That looks great, and then they're planning some musical events. So again, if you haven't had a chance to get there, I highly recommend it. And Boy Scouts did a great Eagle Scout project up there. They restored the windmill, so the place is really looking really great.
Yes, I agree. Chair, yes. Why don't you go visit the jewel of Putnam County?
Absolutely. It's something we should all be proud of as Putnam County residents. The place is beautiful. I know it's open on Thursday night, Friday night, and Sunday night for dinners, and Sunday for brunch. Please go take a look at it. Just walk the grounds, see the animals. It's fantastic.
Not to be left out because it isn't my district. It is a great place. Everybody should get out there. But getting back to the resolution, there is a zero fiscal impact because of the anticipated estimate revenue increases.
Absolutely.
That's a brighter side of this.
With that, all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. 6E, approval of budgetary amendment, Deputy Commissioner of Planning, temporary. Again, this is accounting, just moving dollars in proper lines from temporary, or to temporary, I should say.
Okay. Any comments or questions? I'm sorry, any discussion on this? All right, good. All in favor?
Aye.
moving on to Audit Administration Committee. I chair that committee myself, so I'll move the following forward. Item 6F is the approval of budgetary amendment for the Health Department, Transportation, Preschool, and Early Intervention Programs. There was a need, and we need to fund this program, make sure we get the kids to the school and do the right thing for them. It does come with a fiscal responsibility of $41,426, but again, we're paying our bills and making sure these kids have proper transportation to school. Any question, any discussion?
This is because the children have, there's an increase of children in this program, and we're transporting these kids all over, you know, downtown, and there's definitely a need for this. It's a great program, and just helping these children at an early age really benefits them and the county in the future, so.
Thank you, Legislative.
It costs us money, it's a good thing.
It's money well spent. Any other question, any other comments? Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Item 6G is the approval of budgetary amendment for social services, multidisciplinary team, child advocacy grant. This is incoming money to Putnam County in the amount of $27,349, and we will use the money appropriately in the child advocacy center. Comments, discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Item 6H is the approval of budgetary amendment for social services, the Office of Victim Services Forensic Grant, again, this is with Child Advocacy Center again. This is grant money, incoming money to Putnam County, which is always a benefit for the taxpayers of Putnam, $80,224. And we will use the money appropriately. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. With that, we will move on to item number 7, this other business. Any legislator has any other business to discuss tonight? And then we'll move on to item number 8, recognition of public for agenda items tonight. Any member of the public would like to step up and state their name? Item number 9 is the recognition of legislators. Any legislators wish to be recognized? Legislator Switzmore.
I would just like to remind everybody that the Putnam Heart Walk is on Sunday, April 22nd at the Brewster High School. I know everyone has somebody in their family that's been affected by heart disease. And this is a great day to do a, I think it's 3 mile walk around. And we all have teams, and I have to say, last year the Putnam County team was a little light. So anybody from the county, my fellow legislators, it's, you know, it's a great day. So, and there's a lot of great teams, and it's a huge team. So let's not, you know, let's show our support. Come out and sign up for this walk.
Sounds great. Any other legislators? Mr. Sullivan.
Thank you, Chairman. I'd just like to mention to everybody that yesterday, the county executive kicked off the shared services panel meeting, and very happy to see that we had almost 100 people there that were from, you know, the town supervisors, the village mayors, police captains, fire department captains, EMS, school superintendents, a lot of people, you know, were there. And the whole point of the initiative is to look to try and save taxpayers' dollars through whether it's more efficient government, consolidating, sharing of services, and really looking for innovative and new ways to save taxpayers' money. So yesterday was the first kickoff of the panel, and then fiscal vision, which the legislature past Chairwoman Nassarino and myself are co-chairs of that. We're going to have a meeting on February 22nd, where again the supervisors from the towns and the mayors and the villages will be there, and we're really going to start putting some thoughts together and plans for what we could look at and what we're going to work on over the next 6 months.
Legislator person. Any concern?
Okay, speaking to the shared services, we are always seeking ways to generate savings in Putnam County, and we are currently looking into the possibility of extending the life of our vehicles through a truck and bus washing facility. And this would be combined of school, county, and school. So I'm happy that we are moving forward, hopefully moving forward with that.
Just to piggyback on what legislators saw, just state your initial legislation. These ago, we're excited about seeking new ways to save taxpayer dollars and efficiencies. And one of the prospects of our fiscal vision is to seek ways to present. We are an advisory board, but we are excited about reestablishing this committee and moving forward this year and bringing some of the things to the table.
Chairman, I'd just like to report that last Friday, the task force involved with the proposed sewer line running from the city of Danbury down to the village of Boosterman. And we are progressing. We've had substantial conversation with the city of Danbury. We are estimating our flow rates, and I don't want to take too much thunder away from the county executive's state of the county address, because I know she wants to disclose some more detail. But it is seeming to move forward and move forward in a good way.
Great. Good stuff happening. Legislative Sage?
I just wanted to let you all know that February is Teen Dating Violence Month. One of the great resources we have here in Putnam County is the Westchester Putnam Women's Resource Center. If you've seen the signs around town, it is Teen Teen Dating Violence Month. It's a national effort to raise awareness about abuse in teen and 20-something relationships. It's to promote programs and prevent it during the month of February. Dating violence is more common than people think. One in three teens in the U.S. will experience physical, sexual, or emotional abuse by someone they are in a relationship with before they become adults. Help us spread the awareness and stop dating violence before it starts. The theme for this year's Teen Dating Violence Month is love and respect. What respect means and why it's so important in a healthy relationship. So I just want to remind everyone that it's Teen Dating Violence Month, and it's all about respect and awareness.
Thank you for that information. Other legislators wishing to speak? Done. I will make a motion to adjourn. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.